I know who you are, Shrike. I know you blame me for your father's death. I know you think I goaded him into performing a trick he couldn't pull off. I know the time in jail was a result of a 30-year revenge plot against me.
Supposing that's all true, you think I'd tell you no?
30 years. 30 years and the greatest long game magic trick ever created. Just to put me behind bars. Okay. So how did it feel seeing me there? Was it all you hoped?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You're lying. It was an empty experience. You want to know how I know? I know because you know. There's always, always more than what's on the surface.
So what? The past didn't happen and you're not who I think you are?
Now don't tell me in 30 years that's the first time you've asked yourself that question.
I am not my father. You're not getting in my head, okay? You think you're luring me into a trap? You're not. Now, I am desperate, which means I'm dangerous. My only concern is the health and well-being of the horsemen, and you're gonna lead me to them. And if you don't, I promise you, you're gonna end up far worse than in some cushy jail cell somewhere.
What if the horsemen don't actually need you to save them?
All right, so the lab is made up of two distinct layers, the security perimeter and the clean room. The stick we're looking for should be in this core, so we're gonna have to get underneath, extract it, and replace it with a decoy. Now, we're about to get to the chip. This is the thing about the chip, it's very thin. Luckily, it's similar in weight and size to a playing card, so we're gonna have to brush up on our cardistry. Get in? How does Pike? He's the son of a South African gangster. He's RSVP'd with what looks like a couple of members of his security detail. A doctor, to vet it, I guess, and somebody named Buffy.
Yeah, apparently he travels with a different bimbo every week. I wonder which one of us gets to play the bimbo.
In everyone.
The soothing sound of the slots who slip into a serene state of slumber and sleep.
Jack, for a moment they will think you're Hannes, so lead them out and keep them busy.
You trust your people implicitly. You will have them take care of everything, and you will wait in the car, and eyes open wide awake. Go.
Excuse me, these people are following me. You might want to check their pockets.
Then our time is ticking to infiltrate the lab and get the card to the market where I'll hand it off to the ICE so we can all get the hell home.
I made up the same things.
Ah, Hannes, my old friend. So glad you could make it. I knew you had a soft spot for an old-school bidding war. How have you been?
I trust my people implicitly. What they say goes.
Certainly. But I'm sure you'd like to see it for yourself. Hold it in your hands. Check the build quality. Or not. Also fine. Well, if you'd like to follow me. You'll have to remove all your metal, watches, rings, etc.
Yeah, of course.
Excuse me for asking. Where might I have seen you before?
I don't know, probably one of my my many symposia.
The book jacket!
I have to say, Dr. Michalakis, I'm a huge fan.
Oh, thank you so much. Which book? There've been so many, said.
Does Hannes' chippy always talk for you, Doctor?
Doctor?
Sorry, when you say Chippy, you are referring to Buffy here, yeah?
Of course.
Oh, Hannes prefers the term floozy for all of his toy toys.
Yeah.
That's
noted.
Right.
He does. It's good.
By the way, I got your email, Dr. Mithilakis. You had a query about our ability to maintain quantum coherence at room temperature without the use of dilution refrigerators or error correction.